Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Zoom land, people out in Zoom. My name is Sue King, and I'm a lay licensed worship leader through the United Church of Canada. And Wendy and I join you this morning from our home fellowship of Chris Pamsis United. So is there any more announcements other than those that came up on the screen this morning? Nope. I'd like to acknowledge the territory on which we stand. And as we gather to worship, let us pause to remember that in this region we live and work and worship on lands that are by law the unceded territories of the Wabanaki peoples, predominantly the lands of the Mi'kmaq, Maliseet, Passamaquoddy, and Penobscot. May we live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship with its people. Thanks, Wendy. We light this Christ candle as a reminder that the light of Christ within us is there to shine to a world seeking reprieve in the darkness. Something that you may not be familiar with is in Chris Pamsis United, we have become an affirming congregation. And one of the things we do is so people that have hearing difficulty, we have a reader always read the responses. So while you're responding as well, a reader is on the mic, so that everybody can hear the responses. So Wendy's going to be my responder this morning. My first responder in most things, actually. So join me this morning in worship as we come together in fellowship. Come, all who are weary. Come, all who are seeking. Come, all who are seeking hope.
For Christ is on our journey and has walked the desert wilderness.
Come, all who are questioning. Come, all who are lost in the margins.
For Christ is on our journey and has walked the desert wilderness.
Come, all who seek peace. Come, all who seek love. Come, all who seek justice.
For Christ is on our journey, has walked the desert wilderness, and through his journey, we are not alone. Amen.
Loving Christ, you speak to our deepest longings for love, hope, and meaning. You call us into unity with you. In this season of Lent, you ask us to journey with you to the cross and the glory of Easter morning. Draw us close and help us to pray and to reflect and to open our lives to the transforming presence of your Holy Spirit this morning. As we journey with you, may you renew us in following your example and enliven us to be bearers of God's good news of love, compassion, and hope to the world.
Amen.
Join me in this hymn.
Through these Lenten days and nights, we turn to walk inward way. We're meeting Christ, our guide.
Belong to a region, right? What is the name of the region? Fundy Dawning Waters Regional Council. Yes, so we have to get that right before we can even do all the things that the region's asking us to do. And one of the things the region is asking us to do is to form committees of ecological justice. You might be aware of that. It might have come to you in announcements. And, you know, I've been really struggling, particularly in our congregation. How do we teach people about the environment, about caring for our environment? And how do we keep people aware of animals? And, oh, my God, what are you? Oh.
I'm a Drosophila.
A what?
A Drosophila.
You're a fly.
Well, that's what you call me, but I'm a type of fly.
A type of fly?
Yeah.
Well, what on earth are you doing here in our worship? Like at home in Australia, you're a nuisance. You get in our barbecues and in our eyes and in our hair. What are you doing here, fly?
Well, there's the big problem. You only see us as a nuisance, but we're actually a very important part of this world.
Seriously?
Yes, we clean up all the people and things that die, and then we also kill some things that eat your food.
Oh. Well, why would you come and tell us this morning?
Because we need to pay attention. We're all in this together, and we're all part of this world and very important. And you know what? We're not that different from one another.
Here we go.
You'd be surprised. 60%, yes, 60% of your genes are the same as mine.
Really?
They are.
My genes?
And people use me to test out genetic ideas because of that.
What do you know? A fly testing on genetics.
So I want you to realize, even in your Bible, they knew that.
Really?
So from Ecclesiastes, it says, for the fate of humans and the fate of animals is the same. As one dies, so dies the other. They all have the same breath, and humans have no advantage over the animals, for all is vanity. All go to one place. All are from the dust, and all turn to dust again. Who knows whether the human spirit goes upwards and the spirit animal goes downwards to earth? I think we all are part of God.
Wow. Well, I'm flabbergasted. I'm not sure I can go on. But thank you, Drosophila. Thank you. Comes up with amazing things. So we enter our period of scripture, and I'm going to wait for Wendy to return, who's just snuck out for a minute, to join us, but we will start with the refrain and Janet will lead us into that.
And I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on breath of dawn, make you to shine the sun, and hold you in the palm of my hand.
You who dwell in the shelter of your God, who abide in God's shadow for life, say to your God, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. God's wing, your refuge. God's faithfulness, your shield.
And I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of my hand.
You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day.
Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come.
For to the angels is given a command to guard you in all your ways.
Upon their hands they will bear you up, let you dash your feet against a stone.
And I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you the breath of dawn, make you to shine.
they have set their love upon me, I will deliver them.
I will uphold them because they know my name.
When they call to me, I will answer.
I will be with them in trouble.
I will rescue and bring them to honor.
With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my saving power.
I will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of my hand.
Thanks, Wendy. Our scripture today is Jesus being tested in the wilderness, a familiar scripture during Lent. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them, he was hungry. The devil said to him, "If you're the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread." Jesus answered, "It's written, man shall not live on bread alone." And the devil led him to a high place and showed him all in an instant, all the kingdoms of the world. And he said to them, "I'll give you all their authority and splendor. It has been given to me, and I can give it to anyone I want to. If you worship me, it'll be all yours." Jesus answered, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only." The devil led him to Jerusalem and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. "If you're the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to guard you carefully. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." Jesus answered, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to test." Then the devil had finished all his tempting. He left him until an opportune time. We're going to sing an anthem now that my friend Janet wrote. And Janet, as you know, has been very proliferant in writing hymns in the last 3 months and songs. And this was one of my favorites, and I've used it actually in meditation. I've listened to it to help me slow down, meditate, and focus on God. So I hope that it allows you to do the same. Let go, let God.
Let go.
Pray with me this morning as we get an interpretation from the scriptures. Loving God, we do ask that you sigh in our souls today, that as we hear your words, interpretation of a story of Jesus wandering in the wilderness, that these words in his life might impact ours and transform us. In Jesus' name we pray. So the story of Jesus' wanderings in the desert for 40 days is not unknown to us. We hear it generally at Lent. It's a time of reflection. Well, hopefully we meet the influence of Jesus' grace in the middle. It's a time when we seek to find grace and deeper trust in God. It's a time to get past ourselves and the things that often distract or derail us. I will get to why this is important later. So what gets in the way of our own resilience and finding our trust in God? Words. Yes, words. Words replayed and repeated in our brain. And regularly, it's the words in our mind that cause us to lose our footing, seek our own ego, go after our own indulgences, or simply lose faith. We might have a bodily reaction to fear, love, anger, or pain, but it's words in our minds that cause us to unravel and separate us from God, from communion with God, and also from each other. Battles start here. In our brains, I know this to be true from experience. I think you might be nodding your head also. Today, we look at Jesus' journey and the words that taunted him. I hope this is consoling that Jesus was actually in a battle as well with words. He was like us and he was unlike us. Why? Because he was the one chosen to teach us the higher way of love. Today, I hope to identify our wilderness journey and the words that have swum around our heads for 2 years. I'm just going to name this and put it right out there. You might say, oh, Sue, that's a bit dramatic. We're really okay. We haven't really suffered. I beg to differ. How many of us, when we heard that scripture this morning, heard ourselves saying, a wilderness? Yes, Lord. This has been a journey into the wilderness of unknowns, loneliness, uncertainty, change, and losses. If you alone have not experienced those things, I know many that have, and we're all connected. In our world this past week with the news of Ukraine, we know that thousands have been plummeted into a wilderness experience, and we are all connected. I believe that as we draw closer to God in this season of Lent and find our own resilience, it allows us to bond deeper in the spirit for those that are struggling. We are all connected. We in our safety and freedom, as we fast from our egos and self-indulgences, have much to offer into the realm of the spirit through prayer and sending our love to the corners of the world. So let us look at Jesus, who did just this. He was a man in his early 30s, who scripture says had been filled with the Holy Spirit, and he chooses to take this wilderness journey alone. This isn't a foreign practice in his culture. This was an area of desert known as Yeshimon, 35 miles long and 15 miles wide, very sandy, and was called the Devastation, the wilderness. And in the Gospels, interestingly enough, it's more aptly named the place of demons. So metaphorically, it was a lonely, empty expanse of nothingness where personal battles were faced with prolonged fasting and an absence of chattels, people, and comfort. However, the desert was a familiar place for the Jewish people. You might remember they wandered for 40 years. Yes, 40 days and 40 years, symbolically under Moses. For all their griping in the desert, they felt intensely close to God through Moses. God was a pillar of cloud by day and a column of fire by night, a way of saying that God was always with them. They were not alone. So this practice of being in the wilderness was not foreign. And even after Jesus resurrected, Desert fathers went out as ascetics and lived in silence, to be in a wilderness journey to seek God and to pray. So we're told that Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness intentionally to fast, to shift from being Jesus the carpenter to Jesus who would go into ministry. We're told in the Gospels that only angels and wild beasts met him there, maybe a Drosophila or two. It was a time for Jesus to discern his own faith, his own ability to hear and trust God, and to build his own resilience. Unlike us in this past 2 years, he chose this. Let's draw out the similarities in the wilderness. For 40 days, he traversed the desert. Was he alone? Was he cut off from people? Yes. Was he without routine? Yes. Was he without familiar comforts? Yes, indeed. I wonder what he thought. I wonder if he talked and communed with God. I personally believe this is what sustained him. He knew he was not alone. I wonder if he got a glimpse into his future. We don't know. I do sense that he just stuck to the plan and walked steadily forward with intention. I chose Janet's song today, Let Go and Let God, as it has the rhythm of a beating heart. Slowly, it reminded me of Jesus walking, giving over his heart and his mind to God in his fasting and moving forward towards his ministry with solidarity, strength, and trust. We do know that as he neared the end of his 40 days, and possibly knowing there was food and shelter fairly near, he was taunted by familiar longings that could be his if he just denied God's presence, God's sustenance, and God's calling on his life. He was challenged, obviously, by his need for food and to break his fast. He was challenged by the need to access material things for his happiness. And he was challenged to magnify his own ego, deny his need and relationship with God. I believe it was Jesus' own relationship with God that got him past these words, the battleground, I believe, of his mind. Words of temptation. Surely it's time to eat, Jesus. Or, you know, you could be rich and famous. Or the most deceptive one. Don't you want to have unlimited political power? Have it all? Like, just be God. In the face of every temptation, what does Jesus do? He answers the words back. God is enough. God's word is enough. Loving God and putting God at the center is enough. So good people, what's the purpose of all this today? We don't really know how much resilience Jesus had before his 40-day fast, but we do know that straight after it, he entered a ministry of healing. It unleashed a depth of compassion, acceptance to the marginalized that had never occurred before, and speaking of the opportunity for all to become one with him and the one that he called Abba Father. Excuse me. This ministry has turned the world upside down. His journey of the wilderness led him into a deeper way of giving love and being love. So what can and does this say to us as we begin Lent and look back on what we already feel has been a wilderness journey the past 2 years? What if we take time to walk the walk like Jesus did? Seek meditative practices. Listen to Janet's song. Find that scripture that we sung this morning and we'll sing at the end of the service. Breathe, walk, pray. Be in a meditative state of mind. What if we looked back on our struggles the past 2 years as stepping stones today and say to each other when we're seated here in church and home at Zoom, I'm here with you. You are enough. God in you is enough. We've got this. What if it all started to amount to something and we use it to shift our energy and our environment? What if we choose a higher way of using our resilience, which believe me, every single one of you has gained, simply by making so many adjustments, facing uncertainties, and seeking ways to remain whole and healthy over this past 2 years. What if we make a deeper path of giving, a widening of our mercy, and a stronger passion to be the Christ love that people are longing for in this congregation, this community, our country, and the world? May it be so. Amen. Our time for our invitation to our offering. Come, let us ask ourselves how we can give, and in asking, find a willingness to act on what God calls us to do. God, we offer these gifts to you, knowing that you offer us so much more. In this season of Lent, as we journey with you, we ask you to bless our giving and open our eyes and ears to opportunities to continue to give in your name. We enter, oh, that's Australia right there. It's a farm that I know well in Western Australia. As we enter into prayer, let us keep our world in mind. Join me in prayer. Loving Christ, friend for our journey, as you went into the desert, so do we follow. Many of us have been here before. Some of us more recently have found ourselves lost in a wilderness of unknowns. We pray for sight in the dust storms of our life, where false comforts or rescuers are offered to us. We pray for nourishment and your living water to fill the parched areas of our hearts. We pray for the recognition of your voice when others offer shallow offerings. We seek your guidance to show us direction in a world where there are too many signposts. Teach us that in retreating for this season of Lent, seeking you alone, our purpose is to be strengthened to do your service, to feed the hungry, clothe the naked, welcome those who seek shelter and those needing your love. The closer we draw to you, we pray that we will draw others to you also. Today we pray for our world and call out in a holy cry for peace, the Ukraine, and the displacement of so many peoples all over the world. We pray for governments, leaders who daily make complex decisions. We pray for countries still seeking vaccinations and for the thousands of healthcare workers still working beyond their energy in this international pandemic. We pray for those living in the margins, either by their economic circumstances, ethnicity, gender difference or sexual orientation, mental illness, addiction, or separation from loved ones. We pray for this community of Hampton, for its safety, and ask your blessing on the schools, the businesses, and the healthcare centers within it. Loving God, I ask your blessing on this congregation, those present and those absent. Continue to guide them and bless them as they discern their ministry for the future. In silence, we call to mind those who need your love to reach them in their wilderness today. In all these things, we thank you, God, for your ongoing light and love that reaches us. And in communion, we pray the prayer that you taught us to say with you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We're now going to sing that beautiful psalm that we shared earlier as a hymn. And I hope that this resonates in your mind throughout the week.
To the God I rest.
What a wonderful image for us here in Hampton, who, when we're surrounded by so many eagles, what a wonderful image for us to just replace those words in our minds that we'll be raised up on eagle's wings. So grateful for where we are and where we live. It's been an absolute joy for us to be here. My heart is full, to almost to the point of tears, just being with friends. And thank you, God. And also thank you to Janet, to Wendy, and to our tech team that I know are in transformation. And I bless you in that, because Chris Pamsis United has been going through that as well. You're in our prayers for that journey. So receive this blessing. May you know that as you leave today, Christ is the presence who can lead you and guide you. Remember that in a wilderness, you are not alone. May the wind and the comfort of the Holy Spirit comfort you. Receive the blessing of God's perfect love that drives out fear. And go now in peace. Amen.